In a massive show of strength, MLAs of the NCP, the Shiv Sena and the Congress in about an hour from now will be at the Grand Hyatt Hotel. They're setting up a mega photo opportunity. We've got Olami Saha, she's standing by at the Grand Hyatt. Explain the mechanics of what's being planned, because this is not a parade before the governor. The governor now, incidentally, Bhagat Singh Koshyari, is back at the governor's house at this moment. Why is it that they decided to set up this show of strength at the Grand Hyatt? Will there be a ballroom that they've taken? Will it be outside on the porch? How are they planning to do this, Palam? Palami, do you hear me? Give me a moment as I try and fix this. I want to go across also to Kamlesh Sutar and Sahil Joshi, who are joining us at this time. Sahil, explain what happened behind the scenes. How is it that this plan was hatched, that they wanted to parade 162 MLAs all at the same time at the Grand Hyatt Hotel in about an hour from now?
You know, of course, the three party leaders definitely know that this is not a floor test. I mean, you know, showing a show of strength at Hotel Grand Hyatt is not enough for them to get back the power which they think that has been snatched away by the Devendra Fadnavis and Ajit Pawar alliance. What they are trying to do is basically to present a picture not only to the public at large, but also to their own MLAs, that look at our strength. You know, don't buy what Ajit Pawar is saying or what the BJP is saying. We are all together. We have the numbers. Don't go away. We will be forming the government, if not tomorrow, once this Devendra Fadnavis and Ajit Pawar government is fallen on the floor of the house, we can definitely go ahead and form the government. That is the message which they want to give to all the MLAs. They want to show that they are united. At the same time, please understand, tomorrow is going to be an important day, because tomorrow is going to be, you know, Supreme Court is going to decide how the, you know, the vote of confidence test will be conducted. Their decision is going to matter a lot. So, you know, I also think that this might be a show of strength for the judiciary as well, to show that they have the numbers. In the afternoon today, all the three leaders, important leaders of all the three parties, went to the governor house. They gave the letter of support. They showed them that they have 162 signatures. Now the governor will obviously ask the question that if they already have the signatures of the NCP MLAs, now you are presenting the same signatures against whom to believe. So for them, basically, you know, look at the tweet made by Sanjay Raut. He has tagged Governor House in that particular tweet. Governor's official handle has been tagged into that particular tweet. So this is basically you know, the mechanism to send across the message that they have the numbers, and what the BJP and Ajit Pawar are doing is unconstitutional. They do not have the numbers, but despite that, by deceiving people, they have got themselves into the seats of the chief ministers and the deputy chief ministers. So that is what is the message they want to send. They know that finally they will have to show the same strength on the floor of the house, and that's where Ajit Pawar believes that when the NCP MLAs will come on the floor of the house, there will be at least 20 MLAs who will switch over to his side, and him and Devendra Fadnavis will sell through this vote of confidence. And the NCP wants to avoid that and send a message to their MLAs that this is the strength we have, Rahul.
Okay, Sahil, stay on with us. In fact, Kamlesh Sutar also joining us. He's reporting from outside Ajit Pawar's residence in Mumbai. You know, this is all perception battle which is going on at this point of time, Kamlesh, the parading of the MLAs in front of the media. But interestingly, while today, you know, posturing was going on, Devendra Fadnavis went early in the morning to the Mantralaya, took charge as well. Ajit Pawar so far has not taken charge as a deputy chief minister.
Well, indeed, and that is what has elated the NCP. The NCP perhaps sees a ray of hope in that. They feel that Ajit Pawar is still open to talks. He's still entertaining NCP leaders. Not just the meeting that went on in Vidhan Bhavan for 3 hours, but also before that, NCP leader Chagan Bhujbal also met Ajit Pawar, tried to convince him to come back to the party fold. Then Ajit Pawar goes to Vidhan Bhavan, also holds a meeting for 4 long hours with Chagan Bhujbal and other party leaders there. And most surprisingly, for the BJP and what NCP would feel happy about is that Ajit Pawar was supposed to take charge in the morning, did not go to the Mantralaya. What you've learned, that initial the plan was that Devendra Fadnavis and Ajit Pawar would go to the Mantralaya. That is what the right thing that he said. they would take charge and hold a cabinet meeting and announce relief for farmers, just to send across a message that we have taken charge of the office and we have started working towards the welfare of people, especially the farmers who have been facing harrowing times because of unseasonal rains in Maharashtra. That perhaps would, for them, would have changed the picture. But Ajit Pawar did not let that happen. Ajit Pawar did not take charge as the Deputy Chief Minister, putting it on hold for some time till he takes charge. Now Ajit Pawar is still at his residence the working hours are over. Not that he cannot take charge after the working hours, but still, today's day, it seems that Ajit Pawar is not going to take charge. He's still sitting at his home as
truly parties plan and hold a parade in Maharashtra
of all its 162 MLAs. So the NCP
on the one side, we had images of Chagan Bhujbal with Ajit Pawar and Devinder Fadnavis this morning, even though he'd been sent on a bring Ajit Pawar back mission, but he was happily getting pictures clicked with him. Then we've got Ajit Pawar, who hasn't taken charge as Deputy Chief Minister, and we've got Sharad Pawar, who's not thrown his nephew out. In any other state, if you stab the party in this fashion, split the family, you'd probably be thrown out by now, but not in Maharashtra, where everyone wants to cut a deal with the other. Priyanka Gandhi Vadra has tweeted moments before now, attacking Prime Minister Narendra Modi directly, this time referring to his speech in Jharkhand. Priyanka Gandhi says, "Abhi abhi Pradhan Mantri ne झारखंड में भ्रष्टाचार पर मनमोहक भाषण दे रहे हैं और उसी समय महाराष्ट्र में उसे लागू किया जा रहा है अब इनका स्लोगन है वन नेशन वन स्लोगन एंड दैट स्लोगन इज हमारे साथ आओ सारे पाप धुल जाएंगे प्रियंका गांधी वाड्रा अटैकिंग प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी सेइंग द बीजेपी स्लोगन नाउ इज हमारे साथ आओ सारे पाप धुल जाएंगे पॉलमी साहा इज एट द हायत होटल राइट आउटसाइड which is where all these MLAs will be paraded. And I'm very curious to understand from you, Palami, how will this grand parade take place? Will they be paraded outside? We've seen such parades at governors' houses before this. This is possibly the first time in recent memory that there will be a parade of MLAs happening inside a hotel. Have they booked a banquet hall? Are they going to do it outside? And clearly they're trying to send a signal to the judiciary, which will take a decision on whether there is to be a trust vote soon or not tomorrow morning.
Right, Rahul, what we've learned is that all of the MLAs will be paraded inside the hotel itself. They've sought permission from the hotel and the leaders have started arriving as well. You can see that there is a lot of buzz over here outside the Grand Hyatt where I'm standing right now. And in a short while from now, 20 to 25 minutes from now, all of the media personnel who are present outside the hotel will be let in so that this event, which is estimated to take place between 7 to 7:30 p.m., happens. What they're saying is that it will be about, you know, 10 to 15 minutes because it's not that everyone, every one of those legislators, the 162 that they claim, who will be putting up a mega show of strength over here, will be introducing themselves. So they all come together before the media. The media will be placed somewhere at the front. They will come together before the media and they will take a pledge of sorts. Now, what that pledge is going to be, we've not again been told what that pledge is going to be. So clearly, this is a signal that this Maha Aghadi is trying to send out. The Congress, NCP and Shiv Sena alliance is trying to send out to the governor specifically, because when Sanjay Raut extended this invitation to everyone, when he tweeted it out and broke the news, he tagged the Maharashtra governor. So this is a clear signal to the governor that we've given you the letters,
this
the
is
signatures
an evening when signals
with 162
are being sent.
Of them. But if
the
you
NCP,
don't believe
the
us,
Congress
well, here
and the Shiv Sena sending a signal by parading these MLAs. And on the other hand, the Maharashtra Chief Minister seeking to send a signal that all is well, he's got things under control. The Chief Minister's office has put out a public declaration moments before now saying that 5,380 crore rupees from the Maharashtra contingency fund are being given to farmers affected by unseasonal rainfall. So Ankit, signals being sent from both sides. They've got 162 MLAs and Fadnav is sending the message that we're now giving contingency funds to farmers who need this.
And the first, it's very important, the kind of first decision that they have been taking, because a lot of people have been talking about in the last 1 month, there is a lack of governance. The farmers, in fact, are suffering. So the first thing that the Chief Minister does, sends out not only a message to the farmers and trying also to send out a message that he's working for the people of Maharashtra. Rahul, I just very curiously want to understand from you also, this whole, parading the MLAs in front of the media, asking them to take a pledge, is it also somewhere trying to put some pressure on the MLAs as well? Tomorrow, if you go back, because there are still fears that few of them may switch loyalties to Ajit Pawar, if you go back, then you will also have to go back and face the voters after doing this publicly.
Oh, absolutely, because Ajit Pawar and the leaders that he's been meeting has been telling them that don't worry, when the vote of confidence happens on the floor of the House. Many of these MLAs will support me. And Sharad Pawar, realizing the hold that Ajit Pawar has on some of these party leaders, is very worried about that. They're putting as much pressure on the MLAs by parading them here so that they're there under moral and emotional pressure not to go and flip. Sahil Joshi joins us. I'm very curious to understand why Ajit Pawar did not take charge. They went together, they posed in those pictures together at the Mantralay, but Ajit Pawar did not take charge as Deputy Chief Minister. So this decision, which was to be a joint decision between Ajit Pawar and Sharad Pawar and Devendra Fadnavis, is now a decision taken by Fadnavis alone. What's the BJP making of Ajit Pawar's reluctance to take charge so far?
You know, Ajit Pawar is a very unpredictable man, and we have shown enough signs of it in last couple of days that how unpredictable Ajit Pawar can be. But at the same time, what happened today was also unprecedented. You know, he was supposed to go to Mantralay in the afternoon. He came to Maharashtra Assembly, at the statue of Yashwantrao Chavan. He offered his flowers, and after that, suddenly he went inside and had started having meetings with the NCP leaders. The BJP leaders also came down to meet Ajit Pawar when they got to know that he's having meeting with Jayant Patil, Chagan Bhujbal and other leaders. But Ajit Pawar did not meet them. After that, Ajit Pawar left. You know, interestingly, Ajit Pawar still tells them that do not do this. Come with me, let's go with BJP and form the government properly. I mean, that is going to be the stable government. But despite that, once he leaves the Maharashtra Assembly, he goes back to his house rather than going to the Mantralay, which is hardly 30 seconds from Maharashtra Assembly. He directly goes to his house.
That Sharad Pawar has reached the Hyatt Hotel. Sharad Pawar has reached the Hyatt Hotel. We can see that happening right behind where Palomi is. Supriya Sule, his daughter, is coming with him. In the meanwhile, I'm being told that the second bus of Shiv Sena MLAs has also left. They're also on the way. You know, they're doing a lot of good to the hospitality sector in Mumbai, which has been suffering from a bit of a downturn, taking up occupancy en masse and moving from one place to another. So good business for the hospitality sector in Maharashtra, especially in Mumbai. And that's the image of Sharad Pawar and his daughter Supriya Sule arriving at the Hyatt Hotel in Mumbai, where this grand parade will take place, Ankit, in about an hour from now.
It's going to be extremely interesting because Supriya Sule has been putting out all these WhatsApp messages about how the family has been broken. She feels very cheated. Also, as far as this entire, the way things have gone in Maharashtra. Also, at this point of time, let me also bring in Kamlesh Sutar, who is with us. Polumi is at the Hyatt Hotel. Kamlesh is at Ajit Pawar's residence. Where is Ajit Pawar when all this drama is going on? After that early morning shots of him going to the Mantralay, since then, what all has Ajit Pawar been up to, Kamlesh?
Well, the series of meeting continues for Ajit Pawar. After that marathon meeting with NCP leaders, he directly headed to his house in Churchgate. What we were thinking that he would rather go to the Mantralay and take charge, but that didn't happen. His car took a right turn rather than taking the left towards Mantralay from Vidhan Bhavan. He came to Churchgate at his residence, and ever since there have been leaders who have been meeting, leaders from the NCP as well as the allies of Bharatiya Janata Party. We have seen Shiv Sangram leader Vinayak Mete coming and meeting Ajit Pawar. Then we had Mahadev Jankar, leader of the RSP, coming and meeting Ajit Pawar. The allies are claiming that Ajit Pawar is still with us and this government will last, this government will prove its majority on the floor of the house. While NCP leaders coming in here and saying we had Vidya Chavan, a leader of the NCP and MLC. She came and said that I'm sure that Ajit Pawar will come back to the party fold. So claims being made from both the sides, both the camps are saying that Ajit Pawar is still with them. But the man at the moment, the man who is to decide, who is to take that call, is sitting at his house at this point in time, watching this very calmly. That's what we've been told. He'll take his decision. He'll take his own sweet time to take his call. But for now, both the camps are claiming that Ajit Pawar is on their side amidst the parade that is going on.
So of all of this, there's a huge controversy that's broken out around the closure of 8 cases. Remember, there are about 2,600 odd cases that the Anti-Corruption Bureau of the Maharashtra Police was investigating in the irrigation scam in Maharashtra. 8 of those cases have been shut down. This has led to huge charges flying thick and fast, opposition leaders attacking the BJP, saying that this is proof of the fact that Ajit Pawar has been brought on board because of a quid pro quo. That's Sharad Pawar and Supriya Sule arriving at the Hyatt Hotel in Mumbai where this grand show of strength will take place. So 8 of those cases have been closed down. A letter came out on social media, which was from the letters of the Anti-Corruption Bureau. The government and the Maharashtra police is in damage control mode. They're saying that this is not linked in any way to Ajit Pawar, that the cases against Ajit Pawar continue. But remember, these irrigation contacts were given out during the reign of Ajit Pawar as irrigation minister, which is when, and there is this one particular comment of Devinder Fadnavis that's gone viral, where he's talking about sending Ajit Pawar behind bars. So as we're seeing this live image of Sharad Pawar arriving at the Hyatt Hotel in Mumbai, it's a good time to recall that comment made by Devinder Fadnavis, who's now got Ajit Pawar as his deputy. Listen to that comment, which is tracking heavily on social media, a comment made by Fadnavis about how he'd ensure that Ajit Pawar spends the rest of his life chakki, peace-owing and peace-owing and peace-owing, and the manner in which Fadnavis says it is particularly interesting.
Ajit Dada chakki pissing, pissing, pissing and pissing. Ajit Dada chakki pissing, pissing, pissing and pissing.
You know, he says it with Ajit all this Dada emotion. Ajit Dada pissing and pissing and pissing. I think this comment will haunt him. Remember, there's so many tweets, public statements. Let's listen to it once again. This is Devinder Fadnavis.
Pissing, pissing, pissing and pissing. Ajit Dada chakki pissing, pissing, pissing and pissing. Ajit Dada chakki pissing, pissing, pissing and pissing. Ajit Dada chakki pissing, pissing, pissing and pissing.
Okay, and you know, when you look at it now, it looks really terrible, because he's there saying that Ajit Dada chakki pissing and pissing and pissing, and now he's sitting right next to him, having forgotten all about that. Tejas Mehta joins us. Devinder Fadnavis, in his time as an opposition leader and as Chief Minister of Maharashtra, built this image for himself as being a scrupulous, honest politician. In the manner in which he stitched this unholy alliance with Ajit Pawar, a lot of the moral halo that he'd built in the whole course of his political career has now been knocked out of the window.
Well, when Devendra Fadnavis was the leader of the opposition in Maharashtra, we had covered him extensively, and he built his entire, tenure as the leader of the opposition and a strong leader of the BJP largely on this case itself, the irrigation 70,000 irrigation scam. And he was the one who made it absolutely inside the house and outside the house, made it a point to, you know, target Ajit Pawar. So certainly, you know, today them joining hands, of course these are political compulsions under which they have come together, but the choice ultimately, you know, lay with him, whether he wanted to do this or not. And I think that will certainly really weigh heavily somewhere in his mind, in his heart, I don't know. But certainly it does not, show well of the BJP or of Devendra Fadnavis, who has been very categorical that he will ensure that he goes to Arthur Road Jail, as I remember rightly, kept saying that he'll go to Arthur Road Jail. And then this famous, you know, chakki pissing was during one of the rallies, which he said. So this was one of his, you know, the prime cases against Ajit Pawar, corruption charges against, Prithviraj Chauhan's government, that Devendra Fadnavis kept harping on, kept insisting. And of course, the Prime Minister also calling the national, the NCP, the nationally, naturally corrupt party. So the BJP has been targeting them repeatedly. So I do feel that somewhere, personally, Devendra Fadnavis would not be absolutely comfortable, but political compulsions, one can say the least, that would have forced
uncomfortable his... Uncomfortable after having made a decision of this nature. Then to say that you're uncomfortable means very little. In fact, Prithviraj Chauhan, former Chief Minister of Maharashtra, senior leader of the Congress, attacked the BJP for having given a clean sheet in some of these cases to people who were involved in shutting these cases down. Here is Prithviraj Chauhan.
Aaj jo Devendra Fadnavis aur unke upmukhyamantri hain, उन्होंने जो सिंचाई घोटाले के 9 केसेस थे उनको बंद करने का फैसला लिया है, जिसमें देवेंद्र फडणवीस अपने चुनाव अभियान के दौरान ये कहते थे कि वो चक्की पिसवाएंगे अजीत पवार से, उन्हीं को बंद कर दिया.
देखिए मैं क्या बोलूं, देखिए अभी तक देवेंद्र फडणवीस सरकार को विधानसभा में बहुमत प्राप्त नहीं हुआ है, तो ये टेम्प्ररी मुख्यमंत्री है और टेम्प्ररी उप मुख्यमंत्री है, उनको कोई भी अहम फैसला लेने का कोई अधिकार नहीं है. गोपाल गाड़ी ले आओ, गाड़ी ले आओ जी. कोई फैसला लेने का अधिकार नहीं है, लेकिन फिर भी ये गठन बनने के लिए जो भी पूर्व शर्तें थी उसको पूरी की जा रही है। पैसे का उपयोग हो रहा है, पैसे की लेन देन चल रही है।
आपका कहना है सीधा सीधा जो है अजीत पवार के केस बंद करके उनको लालच दिया जा रहा है?
ये खुद ने ही अपने आप उन्होंने केसेस बंद कर लिए, तो ये तो मैं समझता हूँ पूरा भ्रष्टाचार का मामला है और
कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट है।
कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट तो है ही,
लेकिन चवन रिमेंबर दिस स्कैम हैपेंड ऑन द वॉच ऑफ द कांग्रेस एनसीपी गवर्नमेंट, सो दे डोंट हैव मच ऑफ अ मॉरल हेलो, बट हे हु कैन टॉक अबाउट मॉरल हेलोस एट दिस टाइम? Nobody is drenched in milk and honey. There is a BJP MLA who put out a tweet congratulating Ajit Pawar for getting a clean sheet in the irrigation scam. His name is Adyut Wagi. Very quickly realized that was a terrible blooper. He's now deleted that tweet. You're seeing these live images from the Hyatt Hotel. We're slipping into a quick break. We'll go back live to the Hyatt Hotel in Mumbai, which is where we're seeing an unprecedented show of strength. 162 MLAs, 145 is the magic mark. 162 MLAs will be paraded there. They're in a bus. Shiv Sena MLAs at this time are in a bus. They've left the Lemon Tree Hotel in Mumbai and they're on the way to the Hyatt Hotel. This is the first time they'll actually be physically proximate with each other. NCP, Sena, Congress MLAs, they've spent a lifetime fighting each other. They'll be together in about half an hour from here. And you're watching our live and continuing coverage of Pawar versus Pawar, the big Maharashtra power tussle. We return on the other side of a quick break. Stay with us.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.